electronically or mechanically. He blamed them when sewing a shirt by hand took about 14 hours. In 1790, a British inventor built a machine for sewing leather and canvas. It pierced the material with an awl-like needle and made a chain stitch, a single thread catching one loop inside the next, repeating itself. But he just made a model or two. In 1830, a Frenchman got a patent for a machine with a crochet hook type needle that also sewed a chain stitch. He set up a workshop to make French army uniforms, but Parisian tailors attacked. The tailors wanted to protect their trade, so they burned all the sewing machines, as well as his workshop. The first man to patent the type of sewing machine we use today was Elias Howe. Some historians argue that Howe's wife, Elizabeth Ames Howe, invented the machine and put the patent in his name. She would have been the motivation since she was a seamstress and would have welcomed greater speed for a greater profit. The Howe machine had top and bottom threads that linked together to form stitches. To showcase this miracle, Howe set up a John Heering type contest between his machine and five ladies sewing by hand in a Massachusetts public hall in 1845. The machine trounced the seamstresses, sewing five seams before they could sew one. But it was a German mechanic and cabinet maker, Isaac Singer, who made the two-thread sewing machine a hit. Sure, he violated Howe's patent, but he added the foot pedal and about 20 other improvements. In the 1860s, Singer took his machine on the road and demonstrated them to groups of ladies. Singer let the housewives take the machine home and pay overtime, making him a pioneer of the credit plan as well. Even though today Singers have computer chips and 47 stitch options, the basic machine has remained the same for the last 150 years.